zwar zwar nicht Fatigue und die Lokomotivstil von 5140 and 1045. There are two common steel used in the car industry. I come from the University of Michoacán in Mexico. We are about 25 kilometers from Mexico City. You see here, this is a colonial city. This is for touristic information. Then, we have an introduction, specimen experimental setup. Ultrasonic specimen of this steel medical analysis, condition for experimental test. Experimental result for the two steel, fatigue result for the ACSI 4140, fatigue result for the ACSI 1045, fracture surface, and finally conclusion. Now, why study these two car steel? First of all, they are widely used in the car industry. Nevertheless, few studies are available concerning their mechanical properties, in particular fatigue endurance. For the best known reason, the outer non-ultrasonic fatigue test has been reported in these two car steel. In this work, this study the fatigue endurance of this steel under ultrasonic loading 20 kHz, together with the analysis of the fracture surface generated by this loading modality. Now, we begin with the machining of the specimen. As you see here, the dimension of the specimen must fit the resonance condition. That means that the natural frequency and longitudinal direction must be close to the excitation frequency. That means 20 kHz. We have here 53 millimeters, and the next section is 3 millimeters in diameter. Now, in order to obtain the natural condition of frequency, a modern analysis is carried out in order to obtain the natural frequency in longitudinal direction. This result shows frequency about 19,965 Hz, very close to 20 kHz. We have more or less 300 Hz of limit plus 20 kHz minus 20 kHz. That means that the specimen might work to 19,700 Hz or 20,300 Hz. In this range, the machine works. Now, at the same time, we carry out the numerical simulation in order to correlate the displacement at the strength of the specimen with the stress induced in the center of the ultrasonic specimen. That means that approximately 30 micrometers induce the stress around 200 megapascal in the center of the specimen. Now here we have but this is a simulation in order to calculate the natural frequency. As you see here, we have a natural frequency of 20,137 Hz. That means this is a useful specimen in order to work in ultrasonic fatigue testing. Now, in the ultrasonic fatigue testing, we have a stationary elastic wave along the specimen, inducing highest displacement at the end of the specimen, a highest stress at the center of the specimen, in order to fit the condition for ultrasonic fatigue testing. Here we have ultrasonic fatigue machine, and in the other side we have the specimen, the broken specimen for the two kind of steel. This one corresponds to 4140 steel, and this one corresponds to 1041-45 steel. The highest temperature, as you see, is 118 6 degrees Celsius. That is in the moment of the crack initiation and propagation. And the question is, why is high the temperature here? Because the temperature is high because the surface of the specimen at the next section is reducing because of crack propagation, and the log is the same, then the stress instantaneously increases in this section. Now, we are investigating the dynamic of the crack initiation instantaneously with the increase in temperature. This is correlated with the reduction in surface where crack initiates and propagates. There are a correlation between the reduction in surface in crack initiation and propagation and the increase in temperature in this period of time, very short period of time for crack propagation. Now we have here the results, experimental results concerning the 41-40 steel. Broadly speaking, we have around 1 million of cycles for 360 megapascal. All tested was carried out at room temperature and with the load ratio R minus 1. This means 0 mean loading stress. In the other strand, in the other side, we have 300 megapascal for about 10 million of cycles. This is the case for 41-40 steel. On the other side, we have the 1045 steel. Roughly speaking, we have 200,000 cycles for 280 megapascal. And on the other side, we have probably 20 million of cycles for 240 megapascal of applying load. Now, concerning the fracture surface, the first case, is 41-40 steel. Slow propagation crack zone increase as applying load decreases. Does this mean that the measure of plasticity decrease? There are an expansion of the slow crack propagation load, the zone, indicating that the plasticity is decreasing in the same time. Same behavior for the 1045 specimen. Once again, crack initiation is related often with non-metallic inclusion in the case of this specimen for crack initiation at the perimeter of the next section of the specimen. Finally, in conclusion, ultrasonic fracture results are obtained on 41-40 and 1045 steels. Broadly speaking, in the case of the 41-40, for the high level of stresses, we have around, for example, 3,100 cycles. In this case, and for the low applied load, that means 240 megapascal. They have just 10 million for the first steel and 60 million for the second one. The fracture surface present two principal tendencies. Number one, crack initiation is associated with non-metallic inclusion. Or for or located at external surface of the next section of specimen, particularly for the low applying load. And the slow crack propagation zone increases decreases. And finally, ultrasonic fatigue results for 41-40. Still is obtaining investigation are close for reported investigation. And in the case of the second steel, the investigation is for the low applying load, 280 megapascal, and present no fatigue limit in this zone. This is contrary to what others are reported. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.